Please rise and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And this is our 99th YouTube broadcasted video.
Holy cow, Laban, did you just say this is Fast Forward's 99th YouTube video?
Yes, I did.
That is so exciting.
No doubt, Sterling. Before we start with this week's news, we want to take a moment to introduce our new Fast Forward staff for the 2023-2024 school year.
That's right. For Fast Forward's third season, we are 15 members strong and are excited to entertain and inform you on a bi-weekly schedule.
To introduce ourselves, we have prepared a short video for you to meet us, the faces of Fast Forward. Watch now.
I'm Renly Aka.
Annie O'Neill.
I'm Lady Crush.
Yo.
Hi, I'm Cash Garner.
And I'm Mr. Rush.
Hi, I'm Emma Hargis.
I'm Mackenzie A.
I'm Mackenzie J.
I'm Aubrey Lawson.
I'm Izzy Wolf.
Hi, I'm Presley Drake.
I'm Sterling McGowan.
My name's Logan Whaley.
I'm Abe Wolf.
And I'm Dave Payton.
This is our seventh day of the school year. We hope that everyone is off to a fabulous start.
Absolutely. Let's get started with today's Fast Forward segment.
Our Fast Forward sports team is ready with some highlights and results for both volleyball and football.
And they have obtained a bit of preview footage of those teams who haven't started competition yet.
That's right, so buckle up and pay attention as we present you to our first Fast Forward broadcast of this school year.
Over to you, sports team.
What an opening. Nice stunting, Addie, Brindley, Sterling, and Laban.
No doubt. Good morning, Wooden. I'm Abe Wolf.
And I'm Dane Payton. Welcome back to this year's first JRW Fall Sports Tour.
That's right. We want to start by recognizing our girls' volleyball team.
This week on Wednesday night, our volleyball teams kicked off their season with matches against Jackson Creek.
Our 7th grade Lydia Artis dominated the Jaguars in two, winning their first match 25-22 and their second match 25-17.
Coaches reported that Abby Schinkel served really well. Faith DuBois played great at the net and several kills. And Eva Morton passed really well and had some great sets.
Great game, 7th grade Lady Arties. Our 8th grade team lost to Jackson Creek in two games.
Game scores were 18-25 and 19-25.
Despite the defeat, Coach Dalton reported several shout-outs saying that Ayla Oakley served really well and had several aces. And Jersey Huff, Avery Coker, and Carly Holbrook played really well at the net.
Now to send our focus back outside, we are going to show you a little preview footage of our wooden soccer teams.
That's right. Our JRW girls and boys soccer teams and coaches have been working hard preparing for their fall season.
Coach Maddie of our girls soccer team is actively recruiting more players. Right now, their team has 11 players and would like at least 4 or 5 more girls to join the squad.
Seriously, soccer is the ultimate team sport. Girls, really think about taking advantage of this opportunity and joining something bigger than yourself. Also, those interested in joining, please see the office after these announcements.
Our wooden soccer teams will kick off their competition season next week with back-to-back games on Tuesday and Wednesday.
Now, we would like to throw out some information about our Lady Artie wooden golf teams.
Also short on numbers is our girls golf team, which currently consists of only 4 players.
Coach Settle would like to promote participation into this great team and sport.
Those of you ladies that are not currently in a fall sport, please consider coming and joining our Lady Artie's golf team.
Here are some reasons why you should consider joining the golf team. 1. Playing golf not only allows you to get exercise, but being outside and getting fresh air is healthy for both your body and mind. 2. This team has a lot of fun together, and golf is truly a sport that you can play for the rest of your life.
And 3, girls, Miss Settle is your coach. It doesn't get any better than that.
No doubt, Dave. Girls, get in touch with Miss Settle to join our JRW golf team.
Now we're going to send it back to the studio where Cash and Mackenzie will bring you the results from Wednesday's volleyball and football games.
Over to you guys.
Thanks, Dana Dave. I'm Cash Garner.
I'm Mackenzie Higgins.
And I'm Mackenzie Johnson.
This week, fall sports got underway as both our volleyball teams and football teams began their competition seasons. On Wednesday, our volleyball teams took us to the courts at home against 2 very good Center Grove teams.
Our 7th grade teams lost 20-25 in the first set, won 25-20 in the second match, and lost the third game 15-9.
This team played really well together and showed great improvement.
Our 8th grade volleyball team was defeated by the Trojans in 2 games.
These girls showed good sportsmanship and true grit in competing hard and never giving up.
Setter Izzy Wolf reported that she is so proud that the team continues to improve and always picks each other up after every play.
On Wednesday evening, our 7th grade football team competed in their first game of the season.
That's right, they traveled to Indianapolis where they took on the Southport Cardinals.
Here to bring us the outstanding results of this game are Laban Cross and Brinley Acuff, who took to the streets to interview our 7th grade wide receiver, Colt Cragen.
Watch now.
Hey guys, I'm Laban Cross.
I'm Brinley Acuff, and this is our 7th grade wide receiver,
Colt Cragen.
Today we are going to interview Colt about the game on Wednesday against Southport. What position do you play?
Wide receiver.
What was the score?
48-0.
Oh, yeah! Oh, my gosh, Colt. You guys whooped them. Tell us about the game.
So, it started off like there was a lot of flags in the first, and we didn't even get to be on offense. And in the second quarter, Jackson Phelps scored 4 touchdowns. And in the third, Preston Whitaker scored 1, and myself, Colt Cragen, scored 1. And it was a great team effort the whole game.
Oh, what are you looking for the rest of the season?
A lot of wins, but it's going to be a tough game against Whiteland.
Thanks so much for joining us, Colt, and best of luck for you guys, you 7th graders.
Back to you, Mackenzie and Cash.
Dang, 40-0, nice win, 7th grade football.
No doubt, keep up the great work. Guys, that's all we have for this week's Wooden Spring Sports.
Athletes, thanks for a great week of sports.
We are going to leave you with a bit of inspiration to take you into the weekend.
That's right. Listen up, guys.
Winners are not people who never fail.
Winners are people who never quit.
Now let's take a moment to celebrate our wooden birthday.
Bye! Bye.
Thanks, guys. I'm Logan Whaley.
I'm Vincent Rush.
And I'm Presley Drake. Congratulations to all our John R. Lynn Fall Sports athletes for a great week of practices and competitions.
Absolutely. Next week, our cross country, golf, and soccer teams will join the volleyball and football teams in their competition season.
That's right, Logan. Here's a look at next week's schedule for John R. Lynn Sports.
Tomorrow, our cross country team will kick off the season against the Braves of the Indian Creek.
On Tuesday, our boys and girls soccer teams will kick off their season away in Indy to take on Perry Meridian.
Also on Tuesday, our 7th and 8th grade volleyball teams will travel to Bloomington to battle the Bulldogs of Bachelor.
On Wednesday, our girls golf team will kick off their season against Indian Creek, and our cross country teams will be away at Decatur.
Also on Wednesday, both our boys and girls soccer teams will host Clark Pleasant at MHS.
Finally on Thursday, our 7th and 8th grade football teams face off against the Quakers of Plainfield. 7th graders will be at home and 8th graders will compete away at Plainfield.
In addition, our volleyball team will be at home next Thursday, August 24th, hosting Franklin.
Everyone get out there and support our fall athletes.
Absolutely. The fall seasons are so fun and there are so many opportunities to cheer on our RE teams.
As we end our sports segment, we would like to leave you with a piece of advice from our very own John R. Wooden himself.
Success comes from knowing that you did your best to become the best that you are capable of becoming.
I really like that one, Logan. Good luck, Wooden athletes, and go Hardies!
To be an 8th grader, but I'm also pumped to be a reporter who will be coming to you regularly right here on Fast Forward.
Absolutely. Guys, if you ever have ideas for stories or have events that you would like us to promote or inform others about, please notify any of us reporters or reach out to Ms. Fraley directly.
That's right. Fast Forward is our student-run communication platform to spread the word to each other and our community about the happenings right here at John R. Wooden Middle School.
You can view our segments on Fridays during success periods.
And you can check us out online via our John R. Wooden Middle School Facebook page and our Fast Forward YouTube channel.
That's right. Everyone, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is at FastForward411.
Now that we have that 411 complete, we want to let everyone know that our first mixer of the year will be this coming Monday, August 21st, right after school.
That's right. This back-to-school mixer will take place from 2:30 to 4 p.m.
The price to attend is $4 per student, or $3 if you bring a canned good to donate to our food pantry.
All attending will be expected to have rides promptly at 4 p.m.
Everyone mark your calendars and be at our first John R. Wooden Mixer of the Year.
In other news, our music department has a big announcement about an upcoming opportunity for both singers and dancers in our school.
That's right. Watch now as we show you an ad created by MHS student Max Littell.
Tale as old as time, true as it can be. Barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly. Just a little change, small to say the least, both a little scared, neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast.
This is seriously amazing that John R. Wooden students can actually be a part of the high school's Beauty and the Beast production.
It truly is, Izzy. What do you think? Should Sharpay and Gabriella try our hand at Beauty and the Beast?
Absolutely.
Again, for those of us John R. Wooden students interested in being a part of the high school's November Beauty and the Beast production, vocal auditions will be on Tuesday, August 29th from 7:30 to 8:30 p.m. and dance auditions will be on Wednesday, August 30th at 6 p.m.
Those interested need to contact or see Mrs. Long for music and additional details.
In the spirit of positive disclosure, our John R. Wooden National Junior Honor Society leader, Ms. Matthews, has shared some great news with us regarding this coming spring.
That's right. Mrs. Matthews informed us that we have been granted $5,000 from the Community Foundation of Morgan County for our third annual Packaway Hunger event.
The date for this event has been set for Friday, March 15th, 2024.
Because the grant amount is half as much as we had last year, we need to fundraise the other half.
We can use the help of our school, family, and Martinsville community to raise the remaining money to fund our Packaway Hunger event.
Students, teachers, parents, and community members, you can help by sharing and donating to our John R. Wooden Middle School Hometown Hunger fundraising page.
Here's the link to donate.
Please contribute and share this link so that we at John R. Wooden can help the hungry right here in our own community.
Guys, this concludes our first Fast Forward segment of this 2023-2024 school year.
To continue with our tradition, we would like to leave you with an inspiring piece of advice to end this first full week of school.
We have now opened our new chapters for this year.
The pages are completely blank.
We will add the words and pictures ourselves.
Our book is called Opportunity.
Let's start this first chapter amazingly.
Make every day count and push yourself to be the absolute best you can be.
Have a great day and a wonderful weekend.
See you at the Mixer on Monday.
Bye, everyone.